In this video, I want to show you how to create words in a shape so that your designs can stand out and hopefully get you some sales. Let's go. Thanks for joining me on this video. My name is Juna with Detour Shirts. I've been designing and selling t-shirts online since 2005. And in this video, I wanted to teach you how to do words in an object. I've been seeing this trend lately on Kittl where there's words distorted on an object inside of a shape, and I think this would be really good, especially on stickers and places like Redbubble where people are looking for something really different. This makes your design stand out, and I think this could really help with sales as well. So I'm gonna show you how to do it. There's a couple of ways that you can distort text to make it fit into an object. I have a video right here where I use Procreate, but I think Kittl is a great way to do it too. You can see examples of other people doing it. I'm gonna show you how I do it. They have a great distort feature for their text, and so we're gonna use that. Now you can just use the shape, or you can make, and the shape would make a great sticker by itself, but I think if you use the shape and then put text around it, it can also make a great t-shirt. So I'm gonna show you both ways in Kittl. It's gonna be really easy, step-by-step instructions, and then you can go and make your own. There's lots of shapes that you can use and put text into it. Think of the different holidays, the different occupations, the different hobbies that people like. You know, you could put it inside of a football, you can put it inside of a state, you could put it inside lots of different silhouettes. You get outdoor silhouettes like deers and bears and all of this. So you can use these ideas and make your own and just go crazy with it. I think it'll do really well. So let's get into Kittl right now, and I'll show you step by step on how to do it easily on Kittl. So here we are on Kittl. You can see right here, kittl.com. And what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna start a new project. So you can click right here, new project, and it's gonna ask you, well, it's not gonna ask you what size, but you're gonna need to change the size if you wanna do it for merch by Amazon or Amazon merch on demand. Right now, by default, it is 1200 by 1200, which is, it's a nice size, but I'm gonna do 4500 by 5400. And I'm gonna confirm that. Boom, so there we go, 4500, 5400. Now I'm gonna wanna put my design in here. The first thing we're gonna look for is a silhouette. So I'm gonna do elements, and I'm gonna type in here, silhouette, maybe animal. There's lots of silhouettes, so animal. Let's see what we got. So not all the silhouettes are on here, and you can make some of these silhouettes by just changing them all the same color. Let's see, like you got bear here, cat. Let's see. I was thinking of doing a different one. You can see some of those. I want something like big that takes the space. So you want to look for silhouettes that have a lot of space in between. Like this one would be cool. You can fit text in here, right? But you wouldn't want this one, right? That would be hard to write in, right? So look for silhouettes that have a big space. I really wanted to do like a crab or something. So let's just do crab. There's that crab. Is that crab? I believe there's a silhouette of a crab. This one? Maybe that one. Let me just do crab by itself. Yeah, there's this one. So you can see there's a bunch of different ones. There's that one. There's that one. Let's do this one. I like the look of this one right here with the eyes. This one's kind of hard to tell that. I mean, it is a crab, but let's do that. Okay. So next thing is to fill the space here like that. So now that you have this, whatever silhouette you pick, you don't have to pick the crab. But in this case, we're gonna put some text in here. And so let's do some text. You can go to text right here, or you can just type in T or hold down T, you can see right there. And I'm gonna do let's do that bigger. Look for the diagonal arrow and then just scroll up like that. Whoops. You may wanna lock this down, but you can. I'm not gonna do that right now. It's behind here, so you could lock it down. And then let's pick a text. So let's find one. I don't want Roboto. Maybe this Adventurer 3. And let's do that. So One way you can do it, well, let's color it first. There we go. And then we're gonna use this distort feature right here. So then I'm gonna zoom in. So to zoom in, we can do this. Click that plus button down there, and then we can just lift it up like that. Whoops. I'm gonna lock this down. So let's back up. I'm also holding down option and scrolling. You can do that for zoom. I'm gonna move my face away so I can show you how to lock this down. So we'll have the crab here. Let's go to layers, and you can see that illustration. You might wanna like name it too, crab, and then you can press the lock button right there. Object locked, right? So now when I click on it, it's not gonna pick the crab, it's gonna pick this. I can't actually pick the crab anymore, right? All right, now that we got that out of the way, I'll put myself back in. All right, so you can see really easy with the distort feature. Let me zoom back in here. And if I wanna edit the transform, you hit edit transform here, and you can move things around like this. So you can easily distort. And you can do this letter by letter if you just wanna type in one letter at a time. You can do that too, but you can do it as a whole thing, right? And then move this around, kinda play around with the text. If you wanna move this here. All right. And then let's get cracking. I'm gonna see if I can put, I'm gonna type in another text, T here, and let's do get. And maybe the same font here. Let's do white. And I'm gonna hold down option and drag. I'm gonna try cracking here. I'll make this bigger. And let's see if we can fit this with the distort. See, all we're gonna do is drag the line. So easy, just drag the points and make it fit. Boom. Now you also wanna make it readable. So that's important. So if you can, you know, it doesn't have to be totally there. And it can come out of it too if you want. Like kind of get right to the edge. Move this to the center, right? And let me zoom back out. And you can see I'm fitting it in here. Look how easy that was. Let's get cracking. Isn't that cool? Now this itself could be a nice sticker. Maybe we wanna change the color to red. Now that I have it in there, I'm gonna go back to layers and unlock it, so that we can color it. Turn that up. And then if I wanna color this, maybe it's not blue, maybe it's red, right? Maybe like a, for crabs, right? All right, so, but let's say we wanna make a t-shirt out of it. Let's do some text above it. So let's move this down and let's do T again. And change it to that adventurer. And let's do, you can do whatever you want for, I'm gonna say I'm just here for the crabs or something like that. And then let's make sure it fits. And then one nice thing about Kittl is that you can curve this text. So let's do a curve as well. Let's do the circle. You can see that kind of fits in a shape. And then to make that bigger, you just grab on it and then just make it bigger if you want. And that goes edge to edge. It kind of works really well with this crab, right? And then we can make that the same color as the red. Undo the crabs. Let's see. One thing I noticed is I wanted to play with this fun font here. And let's do this. I typed in T right here, but there's a fun font that has all the kind of the text here, and I'll show you why. You can see it says sale and the and stuff like that. The way to see what to do here is go on here and the glyphs right here, glyphs, and you can see all of these. So I'm gonna do the, like this the right here, and then get rid of those other ones. Just so it gives it some like fancy text, right? Unfortunately, there's not crabs there, but we can use some other font here for crabs. Let's see. Let's find one that's good. Maybe something fun like that. Kind of fit it in that space, or we could just use the same one that we had before. Let's try adventure. Maybe it's like this. Could do something like that. And then let's do something on the bottom. Whoops. Holding down option and dragging, I'll do like official crab eating shirt or something. All right. See how easy it is to make a t-shirt like this? Now you may want to fill in the space. So maybe that and that, that's cool. And then like this white space here, you might want to fill it in. So let's do some like bigger and smaller, just so we have some variety here. And then I'm going to look for like stars and bubbles and things like that. So let's do here elements and then do stars. Let's see what we got. We got this one. This is cool. Look, that fits right there. See that? So easy. And then you can change the same color if we were going to make it like the same color. Oh, let's change the color for these two. It's going to be a one color shirt. All right. Just kind of has that vintage look when you just do the one color. And then you can flip it. Do right click, flip horizontal, boom. See how that matches? Let's look for some bubbles or something. Since the ocean, this is cool. Let's try this one. Now you can see this one has color, but the nice thing about Kittl is, let's just take out the color and put red in there. There you go. You can kind of have that bubbling up like this, or maybe, you know, try and fit the, that's kind of cool like that. All right, and then we'll just rotate it on this side, flip horizontal, get the idea. Yeah, oh, and we need to change these to red. Whoops. And maybe one more, I like the underline for the, let's just look for a line. I think underline might work. Nope, maybe line. Yep, let's see. I was thinking something like curve. They have so many. Oh, this one will work. Maybe the other way. See how easy it is to do this and then boom. So now we took this sticker, which you could use this crab as a sticker, but now we made it into a t-shirt too. So, you know, you can have fun with that. Maybe move this to the front. That. Boom. And then I'll show you kind of put some vintage texture on it. So let's do that. See there? That's a nice vintage texture, or you could knock it out. So let's do alpha mask and then clip it. And you can see it has that nice vintage. Let's scroll in here. Look at that, it just knocks it out and gives it that nice vintage look, right? So there you go, I'm just here for the crabs. And we distorted this. Now you can go back in here and try it out with all the different silhouettes. Just use that distort feature. We'll go in here and just go to elements. And like I said, silhouette. Now, did you see that there was a turkey one too? This might be really good for Thanksgiving. So turkey silhouette, let's see. So I just did turkey instead of turkey silhouette. I think it's trying to look for both turkey and silhouette, but here's turkey. And if we scroll down here, look at these silhouettes. This could make some funny, if you have some good funny text distorted inside of the turkey, I think that would be great for Thanksgiving and things like that. But of course you got so many other ones. So have fun with this idea where you distort. Get some ideas on Kittl itself. I'm gonna put this one on Kittl so that you can use it as a template, but there's gonna be so many others. Maybe I'll play around with some other ones too so you can see what I'm talking about. But if you look on Kittl and scroll down, we're gonna see a bunch of other ones right on here. So I'll show you that as well. But have fun with this. I think this will do really good for Redbubble stickers. Again, just the silhouette with some kind of words in it. Look for something that can fit a lot of things. You could even put words in here, right? Inside the claw and put, I think that would be great too, like smaller words in here. Have fun with that too. I just showed you real simple in the big one, but you can do it whatever way you want. Be creative, have fun with it. I think it will do really well. So that is it for this video. Hopefully these techniques really help you get some sales. I think it will make your design stand out. Something totally original, or you can make yours original, right? By changing things around and making different words. And I think they'll make great stickers as well as t-shirts if you put some things around it and do that tall rectangle. If this video was really helpful for you, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you're not subscribed to this channel already, make sure to hit that subscribe button right there. The question of the day for this video is, what silhouette would you use? What silhouette are you thinking? I showed a whole bunch of those on there. There's like bears and turkeys and different things like that. Leave that in the comment. I'd love to hear like your creative thinking about this. If you wanna see more videos on print on demand and techniques and different things to make different designs, click on these videos right here. And as always guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.